Shoulders here for Pylite Eye and his bounty hunter. Looks like it'll be Secret who need to come out strong. But this is it. We're going to begin now our winner bracket final best of three matchup. It's Vici Gaming going against Team Secret. Let's go ahead and throw it now over to our casters. It's going to be Gods and Odie Pixel. Please, gentlemen, take it away.
Thank you very much, Dakota, and a big welcome to everyone here at the stadium, everyone that's tuning in online. We've got Secret versus Vici Gaming, of course, starting any second. We've just got a quick pause at the moment, but Gods, what a couple of lineups we've got here, and just the shit knows the fact that we're going to see Misery Magnus, we're going to see the players come out from them. We've got the classic, the out, the Gyrocopter that we know that Vici are so strong with. We're going to see, this is going to be a treat for anyone that's a fan of Dota 2.
Yeah, Vici Gaming have just gone to their kind of classic picks they've been running last week, stuff they're comfortable with. It's been proven to succeed. They didn't, unfortunately, don't get the Morphling. I don't think any teams are going to let them get the trifecta of the Morphling, Alchemist, as well as the Undying, but this is a good alternative. So, Secret, Magnus, you mentioned it. That's kind of the X Factor pick. We have not really seen much of this tournament at all and have not seen in Misery's hands. So, a very unpredictable pick as far as how it's going to fit into the overall draft.
Yeah, absolutely. And at the same time, though, I feel like it's going to be good because we know how good Misery's been playing this land. We've seen him on Slardar a lot, but this is the man who knows exactly when to initiate and when not to. Every time jumping in with the crushes, it's going to be the same story and with the RPs. And if you can trust him with the crushes, you can trust him with an RP. You know that the RPs are going to be big this game. Misery's going to look for the perfect opportunity to use them. But at the same time, Vici's teamfight, the fact that they're going to have the classic Undying Fenrir, they've got everything to throw back at the side of Secret when they jump in with the Magnus.
Yeah, and we get an FY Rubik. Yeah. I mean, what more could you hope for? Yeah. Rubik versus Magnus. This is one of those amazing matchups in any team fight. Sooner or later, if this game goes on long enough, FY will get his hands on that.
There's going to be RP steals, I am sure. And there's so many nice spells for steal as well. The fact that he's playing against a Bane, you know, someone that you're going to be able to take the Fiend's Grip away. Even, like, just heroes, like, if he's able to get the track from the Bounty Hunter, just having that extra bit of gold, it's, I don't know, this is hard to call. Obviously, the panel as well, a lot of people feeling that Vici Gaming, they're kind of hitting their stride, but at the same time, Secret's just been looking so strong this LAN. It's going to be a very, very close series, and I'm really glad that this one is the best of three today, because if there was going to be a matchup that we want to see three games of, it would be Vici versus Secret.
Yeah, and a possible preview of the grand finals as well, unless one of the other teams remaining has something to say about it. You've got Liquid as well as eHome in the lower bracket, but right now, these are the two teams playing the best, in the best form, and looking like they're most likely to kind of make it to the grand finals, win or lose this series.
Yeah, absolutely. And I think just both the lineups of a whole from both sides have been playing absolutely bang on. I mean, people obviously make jokes about EE's performance and such, but he's been playing really well this LAN. We saw his Gyrocopter's performances the other day. And the fact that VG, obviously, working their way back up here.
I think Super stepped up his play a lot in the mid lane. They had a rough group stage. They got three draws on day one, but Super's individual play, he's proving himself as like a top-tier mid player. Something in the past where he was known for playing like the more boring, slow-paced tempo controllers, where he wasn't playing. He's not even necessarily playing flashy heroes anymore, or even now, but he's still performing well, keeping up the farm. We saw there some of just his stats, and he's really been up there and being a key part of Vici Gaming's success.
Yeah, absolutely. And we heard as well, just in the pregame talk, the fact that these teams have a lot of respect for each other here. They're not going to take this matchup lightly. And I think a lot of people will be hoping that this does go to a third game, and it certainly feels like it's got every potential to do so. I mean, just off the back of the drafts here, I don't think anyone could really say there's a clear winner in terms of coming out on top in terms of the draft.
Yeah, I agree with that. I think this is one of those things which is just going to come down to execution and how kind of, especially the first 10 to 15 minutes of the game play out. You've got heroes like Bounty Hunter that can create unpredictable outcomes, whether you get something like a Courier Snipe, a successful gank on the mid lane, the off lane. It's such a crazy wild hero as far as what it can do in the first 10 to 15 minutes. And even when you get behind, you get a few track kills, suddenly you're back in an even game. So Vici Gaming, it's all going to come down to how much they can secure the Alks farm. You really want to pressure this hero. You don't want to just let him farm up the fast 10, 12-minute Radiance, get the Manta style, get the Boots of Travel, and play that kind of old-school Naga Siren-type Dota. So Secret are going to look to get aggressive, very early on this game, I feel. Once Ember Spirit has the levels he needs to start rotating around the map, I don't expect Envy to stay in the safe lane, continue
farming. No, not at all. And at the same time, from VG, I don't expect Burning's going to be sticking around and not to the safe lane too much. Obviously, Burning kind of considered one of those carries who plays it a little safer. He tends to fight a little less than a lot of other kind of position one players that we've seen at this LAN. But with this lineup, I wouldn't be surprised if we do see Burning turning up to the fight the same times that Envy does to try and contest the fights of the Ember and try and turn them around. And the fact that also we're seeing, of course, Ice Jakira. I mean, that's not something that we get to see every day.
No, and it will act as a pretty good way to deal with the Ember Spirit when you hit that Yule's timing, because you can just instantly purge off the Flame Guard, you guarantee the Ice Path hit, so you can follow that with the Chain Stun out of an Unstable Concoction, a Rubik Lift, and try and burst down the Ember to start off a fight. Easier said than done, because that's where the Madness Counter-Initiation comes into play. Rubik's going to look for the RP Steal. So much craziness can happen that it's just going to come down to the individual plays, the execution in those team fights.
Yeah, and I think, well, talking about the RPs and the fact that we mentioned FY before, it is going to be tricky, of course, for him to get those steals, because you look at Secret's lineups, they've got heroes like the Bane, like the Windranger, two heroes that can take down the Rubik and just take him out of the fight with a Shackle Shot, with the Nightmare, or even a Fiend's Grip, just to make sure FY doesn't get his hands on it. And, at this point, when you're going up against FY Rubik, a Fiend's Grip on FY is not a wasted Fiend's Grip if it means he doesn't turn the team fight around.
Absolutely. And for those of you wondering, we are just waiting on the players to return. It looks like one of them taking a quick bathroom break, but everything seems to be getting sorted out. Players having some fun drawing on the mini-map as always.
Oh, yes. Yeah. Fantastic stuff. And well, it's... We got everyone in the booth. I think we're getting there. We do apologize for the wait.
I love how the captains, when they pause, they always have to like point out whose fault it was. Like, first it's like, it's Paul's microphone, Envy's microphone.
Yes, I mean, it wouldn't be anyone else's mic, would it, on the side of Super Road? That's classic Envy.
This game, though, it's just going to be huge. This is the game that I hope really goes three games. If we get the full three games, it's going to just be an amazing series. I don't feel coming in, either team had a big edge. I slightly favored Secret. The panelists were saying Vici Gaming, even some of them saying Vici Gaming 2-0.
Yeah.
What do you think, Owen? Like, if you had to call it, which way is it going?
I was feeling Secret off the back of the performances that we've seen so far, personally, but I would not be surprised at all if Vici take a game, and it is very close. I think it's very hard to call, and the fact that there's so many differing opinions, everyone saying either 2-0 one way, 2-0 the other, 2-1, and there's not really a clear kind of overall decisions, and I think that just goes to show how close these two teams are going to be this match, and I'm just looking forward to some really good Dota 2 once we get it started. And it looks like we're getting there. Envy's joined himself into the game. And just looks like we're waiting for one of the players of VG just to return to their point. And we should be able to get on. But, as you said, you don't reckon we're ever going to see the trifecta come out from VG. No team's going to let them do that with the Undying and the Morphling.
I think the only way you can try and...
We're starting. Let's go.
Yes. We're good.
Come on. There we go.
Another time. So, here we go. First rotation's coming out. This is where you see the early TPs. Look to get down some wards where possible. We'll hop ourselves into the game. And it is Vici Gaming versus Team Secret. Here we go.
Come on! Woo! That's right. Absolutely. I think this game, if any, deserves a round of applause like that, because, we're good to go. We're good to go. And already, Pi light died.
Oh, early D ward from Pi.
Very nicely done.
Doesn't get the other sentry.
FY's not going to give away that he does have the vision here at the moment. Bringing in Burning. I's got to be careful if he goes back up near the Rubik, but he's going to keep it safe, stick to the lane. Make the smart way around. I also got Super hanging around here. But in terms of the lanes coming out from both sides, it's pretty much going to be the standard stuff we expect. Fenrir probably heading top on the Undying with Ice on that Jakira to put on the pressure on Envy. Pala die. 7 minute summit to Burning. Yeah, it's got the Orb of Venom here as well, so...
Yeah, just any cheap early harass you can get off always going to be valuable. We'll have to see which rune the two teams look to go for. It looks like we won't see a squabble over them, as it seems Vici Gaming going to commit towards top, and Secret expecting them to be bottom, because I really feel Secret want to stop the Alk getting a level 1 bounty rune if possible, but it doesn't look like that's going to be the case.
Yeah, I think they would have seen, obviously, Burning on the Jara, and Jara being a very strong kind of level 1 team fighter, just... kind of guessed that he would have been with the rest of the team, but it wasn't the case. And yeah, the fact that they do get that out bounty rune straight up, and that of course is going to be the brown boots first coming out for him in the mid lane, which we do sometimes see Alchemist up for rather than getting the bottle first up.
Yeah, A bit better against the constant harass that can come in from a bounty hunter just to have the movement speed. When he's got an orb of venom and you've got one base armor, you do not want to give him any chance to get off extra right clicks. So a safer opening compared to the bottle. And he's got the tangos as well, so he's got plenty of HP regen.
I'm already seeing already. Pilot Dodge is trading hits here with Super. Baron's going to come in, drop down a decay. So Pilot Dodge's got to be careful. They have got this sentry down at the moment on the side of VG in the mid lane. So there is that protection here for Super when Bounty Hunter does come in for a bit of action. And, oh, in fact, we are. He's got to be careful. They're going to try and turn onto Fenrir, but he's got a couple of stacks of decay at the moment. Just going to be able to force him back here. It's going to be interesting to see how much action Pilot Dodge can find across the map here on this Bounty Hunter in the early game.
Yeah, he's already depleted his mana, has the one clarity, but his big thing is going to be trying to help rune control. He does not want to let Alchemist get too many runes, especially if he's finding bounty runes. That's where Super will just power farm in this mid lane. So I expect to see Secret look to camp both runes if possible, send Misery bottom, send the bounty with the Windranger towards top, for example, and really try and shut them down and control it.
On top lane, just getting the Slurzy onto Puppy. He's going to turn around with a brain set. Pilot dies hanging around as well. They'll just start to trade hits with Fenrir. Gonna have Ice backing up. Pilot Die caught in the middle of it, bringing Fenrir rather low, but he's still got the mana here for the decay, so just turn around and do it. So, just trading harassed across the map in the lanes. No one getting themselves too close to dying. Envy needs to be a bit careful here. He has got backup, but Envy's getting low pretty quick. Gets the chains onto Fenrir, and Envy, that's your first blood for Ice on the Jakiro. Envy, he's doing a bit of window shopping there at the side shop, and it didn't end up going very well for him.
No, he thought just by buying the poor man's shield, he'd be tanky enough to get out of there. And a bit too greedy from Eternal Envy. Something he's kind of known for, and he gets punished there.
Yeah, they're going to be very happy though with that on that offlane duo here from Fenrir and Ice. That's a fantastic way for VG to start the game. And they're playing going back as well in terms of CS. Super, you know, he's keeping Met on par here with Weehaw in terms of the last hits. 12 and 11, so still very close here in the mid lane. And he's just backing up, bottling up, making sure that there's no chance of Pilot Die getting the Courier Snipe out, which they've of course got to be aware of him being on the Bounty Hunter.
Yeah, very annoying stuff. The Bounty did stop the Alk getting the top Bounty Rune as well, so... So far, so good. Secret denying him one Bounty Rune, but giving up the first blood means their lanes aren't looking all too strong here. The Undying Jakiro is going to pressure the Ember a lot. You can't rely on the Flame Guard too much when the Liquid Fire is being spammed out. And Mag, while they're getting levels in the bottom lane, there's a lot of kill potential coming out from a Rubick Gyrocopter, so he's going to play very cautiously.
Okay, now moving in with the Flame Guard. They get the Syrian change onto Fenrir, but he turns around with the Decay. Still got a Soul Rip. He'll clap it. No, Pilot Die goes for the kill, and he gets it. They do lose the Undying. Yeah, they're trying to move forward for more. They aren't going to quite be able to go for that one. They'll just back themselves up. And it will just be that trade they're going on the top. Jakiro getting Pilot dying and Bane managing to get the Undying in return.
Yeah, not a really big win for either player, I feel. Maybe slightly favoring VG Gaming, but Puppy getting the kill. If it goes to Envy, you're probably a bit happier on the side of Team Secret. Once again, they just TP back in with the Undying, and again, Eternal Envy under a lot of pressure. He is not getting much farm at all.
Yeah, 12 and 1 at the moment. You compare that to what? Burning's 20 and 11. I mean, Burning's having a great time down here against Misery on his own.
I think those does have a bottle, so some decent enough farm coming out from Magnus, and this goes along with him wanting to control the rune.
Oh, he's got a skewer here, but the Rocket Blast damage is a fair bit. The Fae Bolt as well, he's incredibly low, bossily up there. Can he get himself out of the Rocket Barrage? They'll get himself out of vision. He tries to juke it around. Can he do it? Misery, look at the blades. Can he get himself to that direction? Oh, he can! Misery! He gets away with it. And even Puppy just comes in and takes the bounty in from under the nose of Burning.
Meanwhile, they lose Windranger at the top rune, though.
My goodness, Fenrir now chasing down Paladai, but so Misery denies himself to Roshan. Puppy takes the rune, but as you said, they do lose Weehaw at the top rune.
It looks like Weehaw got caught by surprise by Alk having a level 2 stun. He's actually only gone for 1 point in Grievous Greed, and I don't think they were expecting that. Windranger, not a hero you expect to die this early on to an Alchemist. The Undying did come into the picture, but Ranger normally very capable of kind of surviving that kind of game.
Oh, top lane. Pilot Knight trying to move in, but there's a sentry down and they just melt him. Fenrir and Ice. They turn around, take down the bounty hunter. Now, let's try and press this forward. Still just level 4 here on this Envy Ember Spirit, so he's got to be careful. And Just the power of the Dragon and the Dirge. It's just so much here on this top lane, and the fact that they got those early kills means you're going to have to send some kind of help up, and that's exactly what Secret are doing. They've got four heroes now converging on the top lane. Puppy, he's going to try and lead in and find maybe a Nightmare setup. He really wants Ice. He doesn't care about the Undying. He wants to kill the Jakiro. Misery's there as well. He's got the Shockwave and the Skewer. They'll toggle off the Nightmare, trying to get the Ice Jakiro out there. They'll look for Fenrir and take down the Undying almost certainly. He tries to turn around with the Decay stats, keeping himself alive, but they'll get themselves one kill. But he does manage to save Ice there with the Nightmare toggles.
Yeah, they keep the more important hero alive. They could have tried to toggle a few more times, but most important thing is not letting Daryl go down.
Yeah.
He's kind of the key hero to get farm on in this offlane. The Undying was out of mana anyway, so by dying, he can respawn, come back top, and continue to pressure. Jakiro just not needing mana to pressure this lane since he can keep spamming the Liquid Fire out.
Yeah, and of course, this did cost Secret a bit. They sent a lot of heroes up top. Bottom lane, Burning still having pretty much perfect CS here on the Gyrocopter. And we talked about how the Gyro and the Ember Spirit may be looking to fight early. And the thing is, if you've got double the amount of farm here on Burning, he's just going to be so much more effective in these early fights with the Ember Spirit.
Looking for a Bounty Rune at bottom. Super will not get lucky here.
Yeah, top. We all would say that. Level 6 now on the Wind Ranger.
Wow, Burning already with a TP scroll, by the way. Level
okay.
4 only, and he's looking to counter gank.
Yeah.
Doesn't necessarily mean he's going to use it pre-level 6, but if big dive comes their way,
they
see something.
He's going to find FY here. That's got the backup of Misery coming. FY could be in trouble. They'll skewer forward here. They won't quite get the slow. FY turning around with the telekinesis, throwing Misery back. The orb of Venom still ticking in. FY. I think, yeah, he's down. Nothing he can do here. Traps himself in the corner, so Pilotar will be able to pick up the kill there on Sir Rubik.
Bringing the support bottom lane, leaving the bounty, or taking the bounty hunter down bottom lane. This top T1 tower continuing to get spammed by the Liquid Fire, so over time, Vici Gaming will be able to get a fast tower and a lot of gold going the way of their entire team.
And Envy's still got to be very careful. Just a single level 5, one more creep will put him up to the 6, and at that point, it will be a little bit harder for Fenrir and Ice to catch him out with no real kind of reliable lockdown to stop him from remnanting away when they jump in.
I have to see where Super goes next. He's still leveling up the stun. It feels like he really wants to play a more utility fighting alchemist rather than the super greedy farming one. Phase boots, the magic wand, all items built towards the early game, and perhaps recognizing that Secret have gone for a very early to mid-game centric draft that's going to apply a lot of pressure, and he couldn't get away with the Grievous Greed Radiance Rush.
Salt lane as well, Misery's TP'd in. And this is Misery's been very aggressive across the map, and this is of course before he has that RP online. He's been able to find involvement in a couple of kills so far. If they can get a wrap around here with Puppy, maybe they can try and go, but there's three heroes here, and they want to dive in on Envy, potentially, with the creep wave moving in. Pings come out, so they notice Misery's here, and I think they're very aware that Secret is set up for some counter initiation, so they're going to play it safe here, almost certainly, VG, and maybe wait for the side of Secret to come to them.
Yeah, and Secret are just hoping for VG Gaming to go in, because otherwise, they can't initiate themselves. They'll be fighting into a Tombstone, a level 2 Decay, so all it takes is neither team to engage, and then Vici Gaming will slowly get the tower, and Secret may just have to let this one go, unless they're willing to rotate someone like Windranger, who is actually headed bottom lane, perhaps looking to take advantage of the fact that Burning has been left alone.
This could be a smart play from Secret.
Man, look, this Burning's map sense is just like the best in the world.
Yeah.
He is unparalleled as far as his just overall map awareness.
And top lane, VG take advantage of the fact that they have the full 4-man up there, and they do take the tower here, so more money into the pocket of the team and the Alchemist in specific, as Super was able to pick up that dollar. And I've seen a bit of an interesting item choice here from Super. So first item looks to be the Mechanism.
He's gone full utility. This is the build he used to do when no one was really playing Alchemist. He would run at mid every now and then, not go for the Acid plus Stun build, not really looking to go greedy at all, and mech into items like SMY, sometimes a Blink Dagger. Doesn't care at all about playing that farming late game Alchemist.
Yeah, I mean,
it's a very different take, though, and I guess they don't really have... The mech hero could be the Undying, but the mech timing from an Undying as a support is so late that it's not really going to get much for your team outside of, like, some late-game kind of heal, which doesn't bring, like, you hit an item, and then you go for a smoke, and you can take control of the game, like we saw in some of the earlier matches where a Darkstim mech can really kind of change the tides at 12 to 15 minutes in the game.
I mean, we can see again on the bottom lane, Burning just, you were saying it earlier, just playing it really smartly. I mean, he sees the Bounty Hunter walking past the town. He knows that they're going to try and look for him. He's coming back in. Maybe that's because they know that they're going to have TP reactions.
And he's doing this without, like, Radiant wards here. Like, when the Wind Ranger rotated bottom, there was no Radiant Vision to kind of scout that. Just the ward near the top rune. Burning just keeping himself tucked away and kind of keep an eye on TPs that are at the ready. It looks like both Undying and Rubick could come down here to help him out if needed.
I mean, so now they do have the mechanism completed here on the Alchemist. I mean, do you think we're going to see VG Gaming now try and force a fight as a group, or is this kind of more built so they can TP in and save people are burning? Ice. He's found himself Envy and Weeha. They'll drop the Tombstone in from Fenrir on the high ground. Nice decay as well. The focus fire not quite enough to bring Jakiro down. Now it's Envy on the retreat. FY's going to be there with the telekinesis onto Weeha. Puppy gets the Fiend's Grip off onto FY though, and they can't cast. It's doing a lot of damage here. Is it going to be enough to kill him? No, the Ice Path comes in, but Daryl cancels it, and now Puppy is going to get several power shots going to miss from Weeha. Now with the concoction onto Puppy, they might be able to find the Bane Killers in the acid spray. Super's moving in, turns around with the brain cell. Shackle shots there, but it doesn't quite latch. He's going to continue to chase here. He's got a DD here. Should be able to find Puppy with a few quick slaps here. Soul Rip, one more from Super, should be able to do it. Envy's coming back in. He's got a serious chase. Oh, the Jukes! Puppy, no, it still comes out. He looks to dive himself. It doesn't work. Envy will remnant away, but VG, they get the kill onto Puppy.
Man, they had to work for it, though. Doesn't really feel like they were wasting time though. They were only chasing with two heroes. Burning kind of swung mid lane. Jakiro's there now as well to pressure down this tier 1 mid tower. So Secret really the ones under pressure. They're very reliant on the Magnus hitting a good blink dagger timing right now. And I feel like they need to give Misery a good lane to farm. He's found himself a home at bottom lane with VG Gaming pressuring mid.
No, it's in a pretty shackle, but there's not really any follow-up here at the moment from the side. And they just need to get level 6. Okay, they've got level 6 now, Misery. So that's something. Mid lane. Oh, Ice Path not going to quite catch Weeha, but they'll chuck out the concoction nonetheless, and the space is there for Vici to get themselves another tower, this time Burning claiming the cash. And 11 minutes in terms of net worth, he's sending pretty high up. 1k above Weeha, the highest on the tower is at Secret, and obviously this Alchemist at 6k at the moment, Super, even just having the 1 point in Grievel's gone.
It feels like Secret aren't getting what they expected out of the Bounty Hunter. They picked it as a hero that can find and scout out stacks and pressure the Alchemist a lot, but when an out goes for this stun mech build, Bounty becomes kind of irrelevant. Secret are not able to, I mean, now they've got track gold at least, so if they start finding kills, they can get that boost in gold, but the Bounty early pressure just wasn't possible against very defensive play, very tanky cores. Jakiro's hard to kill. Alchemist, same story. Gyrocopter, great against Bounty because of the Rocket Barrage, and as a result, Pi, he's 1-2-1. And it's just been a VG Gaming change in playstyle that kind of caught Secret by surprise.
Maybe they can get Super if he walks into the smoke, and he will. They've got a Fiend's Grip straight up with the Shackle Shot as well. He did get the ult off there and a fair bit of regen. He's going to be off in the back. He gets it off and he's out burning. Turns up in the corner out to Puppy in the Rocket Barrage as well. Puppy incredibly low, trying to get himself out through the tree line. But here's FY off with the stolen remnant. Sits forward. Burning will play the kill and he's going for more. Joe's 48 got telekinesis on to Weeha. Burning taking up with Fenrir. Weeha's got the win run here, trying to get himself out, but nonetheless, some flashy plays there from FY. As soon as he gets that level 6 online, this man starts to go ham across the map. And the fact that Alchemist doesn't die, they get a Fiend's Grip, a Shackle Shot. The fight's still going. Misery will skewer away here. But this is VG Gaming stepping up their play here.
There's just nothing Secret can really do to defend towers. If VG Gaming just keep plonking away with the Liquid Fire, they've got Super in the front lines with a mech and the HP regen of a Chemical Rage. That 1 plus mech,
yeah.
Oh, that was so close to bringing him down during Fiend's Grip. And Bounty is so bad against this 5-man push style of play. He's very reliant on kind of more scrappy pick-off-centric Dota, and Secret just, there's no pick-offs available to him. Similarly, the Ember Spirit, not great as well at fighting into 5 heroes, not without a few items. This is where you'd see some Ember players go for like a more tanky item build. You get something like Treads, Ring of Aquila. It's got the Ring of Aquila. I think Envy just is kind of very much in the mindset he wants the boss though.
Okay, they're still hanging around. There's going to be the setup here. Ice drops it down with the cooldown. The Rocket Barrage as well onto Weehive. Falling low. The concoction's there. They'll get the kill off the way. Envy's just TPing into 5 heroes. He's going full steep. But he's just going to turn around. They will be able to zip out here on Envy. But they've got to be careful here, Secret. The Ice Path comes out. It's going to catch onto Misery. And we've got the follow-up. They've put a Nightmare onto Super to try and slow down this push. Fiend's Grip now onto Jakiro. Misery has got an RP. She is forward, and he's not going to be able to get it out because the stun is there with the telekinesis from FY. Stopping Misery getting the RP off, and they'll find the Magnus kill. They do lose Daryl on the ice, on the Jakiro, but 8-4 again. Vici still hanging around. Puppy's throwing out Nightmares. Pylite dies. There's going to be TPM from Weeha. We'll see if he can get himself in position. It's just going to be throwing out the power shot, and Vici will back up. And they get away with it again with a significant amount of damage done there to the tier 2 as well. As you said, Vici's push is just something that Secret don't have answers for at this point of the game, 14 minutes in.
Yeah, and if Magnus goes off to try and farm a blink, you're going to lose towers. So he's just there as one of the probably the main wave clearers next to the Windranger. You can just spam Shockwave next to the power shot. And doing so, we're not seeing the mag get blink probably in the next 2 to 3 minutes. Probably be more like a 20-minute blink at this rate, unless Secret can win a fight, get some track kills. The one track that fight. Got tracks off on everyone, but it was only the one kill that Secret could get, and now, while I die, running near a sentry ward.
Oh my goodness. Oh, gets the dust out. Pylai Dai is gonna die, burning on a killing spree. Very nicely done there. Ice with the dust.
And this Yule's came up so fast. Secret have not had an answer to it. It's found way too many pickoffs and setups. Man. And that's where Secret are really just struggling right now. It's kind of like Lina. Like, it's kind of being played like that Lina mid where, like, not quite the same damage, but the setup is just proving too much.
Yeah, play after player from VG at the moment. They'll get Puppy as well in the mid lane. And this is just top class performance here from the side of VG Gaming.
Yeah, talked a bit about the item progression. He's just going to tank up as much as possible as well. Picks up the Sanj, going to go into the Sanj and Yasha, knowing that Vici Gaming, they want a 5-man. He's the front line. If he gets a bit of HP from SMY, then can go into either BKB, Assault Caress, items that can help him push and siege as well.
Nice. Gets the dust out.
Couldn't quite hit the Yules.
But they will get a tier 2.
Another tower.
Yeah.
It seems Secret are very much in the mindset, we've just got to wait for Misery's Blink Dagger. They don't even try and defend by spamming it out with the Magnus. Instead, he's just on the Radiant bottom side of the map in the jungle, trying to just get what creeps he can.
Yeah, 1400 on Misery at the moment. So, as you say, getting closer and closer. Top lane, Envy moving in with a Haste Rune. Just playing here with Burning. He's going to be all right. Keeps it safe, and yeah, it's just going to TP to the mid lane. Are they going to try and level something now? They're just trying to get the farm up on Envy. He, of course, did still get a relatively good timing on the boots to travel, but he's just got to be careful that he doesn't get picked off again. As long as he can keep his farm up, there's going to be the point where it's going to be very hard for the side of Vici to eventually push up to the high ground, especially if they're going to be doing it against a Magnus when he does have the Blink Dagger. There's still a bit of time that Secret needs to buy before that happens. Ice, seeing if he can get the Yule set up onto Puppy here. He's going to play it safe. Doesn't want to dive out too far here, and VG will just hang back there on the bottom lane.
And yeah, Pi getting down a nice deep ward to scout out this Ancient Sack. He's already seen the Ancient Sack, but this will allow him the knowledge of when Burning goes to farm. It's something that Secret will likely want to prevent from happening. Secret have actually smoked up, but doesn't look like they're going to find any pickoffs with this anytime soon. VG Gaming playing very defensive on their side of the map. They are somewhat split up, though, and Burning probably the most exposed currently.
I mean, yeah, this is a bit of a risky play here from the side of Secret. Misery, he is fairly close to the blink, but at the same time, it's high risk, high reward. They get themselves a kill, that will be the blink dagger money, and here we go. Leading him with the Fierce Grip onto Burning. This could be a very clean pickoff. They've got the RP as well to make sure there's no escape here for the Gyro, and the risk paid off. 1900 gold now on Misery. Very, very close to that blink dagger now.
Yeah, with Burning, just no backup.
Oh, again, ice with the dust. Pylai Dai dead again, and the stolen skewer from FY doing it with style. This man, there's a reason why teams don't like to give him Rubik.
Yeah.
He's crazy.
And the kill and Burning definitely slows down Vici Gaming, their item progression a bit, maybe their next timing to get a tier 2 tower, but Burning's got a lot of farm awaiting for him here at the Ancients. Big quadruple stack it looks like, and that's gonna kind of fuel his economy. Even the Alchemist can help out with the Acid Spray to farm this very early on in the game.
Now, talking about the farm, Weeha, he's managed to catch up a bit on this Whimrager. He is closing in on that Aghanim Scepter for himself, and he's nearly found level 11 here, so...
Definitely not as high impact of Windranger as we're used to seeing from him. I feel like that one death at the top room when he died to the Alchemist really set him back. He lost a lot of farm, a lot of just his general momentum this game, and as a result, we're just not really seeing him have much of an impact right now. Instead, it's the Alchemist controlling the tempo of this game.
And bottom lane, Misery keeping tabs here onto Burning. But Misery, he's pretty much got that money here for the blink.
Yep.
So this is going to be that timing that we may see Secret being able to turn around these full 5-on-5 engagements when they kick off, because Vici have got to be very careful, and they've got to play around the fact that this blink RP is now online.
Yeah. Rubik close to a blink of his own, and that's where FY has it even easier to make that counterplay.
Top lane, Envy is being closed in as Vici move forward. Super has been tracked up there, and yeah, Envy's straight out of there. Not want to hang around for any of that action. Pylai Dai scanning out the Ancients, and VG do have a nice stack here. They'll almost certainly want to give Burning that, especially the fact that Pi now reveals himself, so they know that Secret know that they have a stack going.
Pi's going to play very cautiously. That sentry, the creep, can continuously scout him out, and Jakiro's got such an easy setup. He can get near the Bounty Hunter, but for now it seems VG Gaming say, it's time to take another tower. They're three heroes up top. Take it four now as FY arrives in. Without burning, this is a little bit risky, but Vici Gaming, even without the gyrocopter there, can just pop down a tombstone, have Elk in the front lines, and Gyro can quickly rotate to help him out as well.
And we can see at the moment, Secret looking at the Roshan that did enter the pit, but they know that Vici are making a beeline straight for it. A backup. And,
ambitious.
Playing it safe, and it's all about this Misery Magnus at the moment, I feel. This is what Secret need to turn these fights. And bottom lane, Envy, not going to quite be caught out here. He's quick on the reactions, doesn't let himself get used up. Alright, pace has slowed down a little bit now, as Secret obviously being much more careful with their positioning across the map, as they can't afford to lose another team fight against the side of VG.
Yeah, and Secret, for the most part, getting out-farmed by VG Game right now. The Alchemist, a good 2.5k net worth ahead of the Ember, Gyro ahead, and that's before even farming out the Ancient Stack. I think VG Gaming are very hesitant to farm it because they know the Magnus Blink is up, and right now they haven't actually this sentry they placed didn't deward anything, so they're probably expecting Secret to have some vision around the area, or at least Bounty continually scouting it out, so it's a very dangerous stack to go for when they're much better off just kind of five-manning down towers and playing kind of where they're the ones in control, where they're the ones making the jumps onto Team Secret.
Looks like at the moment, so Secret with 3 mid. We up, just focus firing down the tower. Bottom lane, VG going to try and get the push on and finish off this tier 2 hit. Find the second one from the side of Secret. And I don't think Secret will want to look to necessarily defend this, as they themselves just looking for more objectives across the map. We are continue to push mid, empowered up. And top lane Misery. Now he's going to start to clear out the way.
Potential two towers for Weehar. There we go. Let's say that's not something you want to be doing if you're VG Gaming, who will also get the bottom tier 2. So a tier 2 for a tier 1. Oh, Puppy walks into Daryl, but...
Puppy's got to be careful a bit. He's been left behind. Turns around with a brain stab. Nightmares up high size, but FY and Fenrir moving in, and FY gets it with the Fade Ball. Weehar trying to turn it, but oh, he's the stolen nightmare. Holds Weehar back. FY is going to continue to run, but Pylite dies there. They do find the kill on FY. That's one track goal. Maybe they can get themselves some more. They'll get the track up onto Jakiro. He's looking for the TPM, but Misery's there with a skewer, and they will find themselves a double kill for Weehar. Two track kills there picked up by the side of Secret. In a very nice turnaround where VG just a little bit too deep on the map side of Secret, and Secret were ready with the turnaround.
Yeah, 1700 gold going to the Bounty as well as Windranger for the most part. And Windranger, who only recently picked up an axe, has 2k suddenly.
Oh, Ancients here, Envy. It's just going to Remnant down. And it's going to be fine.
All right, so it looks like they should be able to farm the rest of this uncontested.
Let's have the Chemical Rage. Yeah, okay, still half of it left, but they're still going to go for the skew. There is an RP available here. Misery's going to hold on to it. Just doesn't Super stun up himself, hopefully. Super will preemptively pop the mech just in case Secret think about jumping in. But yeah, with the rest of the side of Ichi turning back up in the mid lane, they're going to hold off that fort for a little bit.
Here we have FY's Blink Dagger online, so both teams will have to be very cautious about how they engage in a team fight when you've got just counter options coming out from Rubik, from Magnus, from the Shackle Shot of the Windranger. I don't feel like either team really wants to be the one engaging outside of the Jakiro Yule setup, which is just a very cheap, cost-effective way to engage because it's got such a short cooldown, but you don't want to be starting the fight with a Blink RP.
Yeah, they're going to try and go for Roshan hit. Misery has got a TP, but the fact that VG were able to clear off those tier 2s early is going to mean this is a lot easier for them to go for. They know that Misery can't get her in time, and they're just going to commit. I don't think Secret can do anything really to stop it without Misery being around in the nearby. And looks like VG will get themselves the Aegis in.
Oh, there we go. No contest. Magnus just stays at the top lane. We'll get a T1 tower in exchange, but Secret not feeling confident enough in their ability to team fight.
I mean, what is the game plan here for Secret? They are still getting a decent amount of farm on their cores. The Ember Spirit, EE, keeping up. Only about 1.5 behind the Gyrocopter. He's now got that Battle Fury. And we've got to remember, as this goes on, if you hit an RP and you've got Battle Fury and Empower on your Ember Spirit, that is a hell of a lot of damage in the team fights.
I feel overall Secret are going to look to play scrappier. Find pickoffs, catch Vici Gaming when they're split apart or on the retreat. When we saw them get the two kills around bottom lane, it was after Vici Gaming were five-manning, but they initiated when they were backing off. They saw the Alchemist TP to the tier 2 mid tower to defend. They knew that Vici Gaming were on the retreat, and if they caught anyone, it's a pickoff and not a 5v5 team fight. That's where Secret aren't what ready to do. Even with the Magnus Blink Dagger, they're going to use this more for pickoffs with Blink Skewers, even a Blink RP just onto like one or two heroes. You find a core hero like a Gyro or an Alk, it's worth an RP. And the 5v5 teamfight just too heavily favors Vici Gaming with Jakiro, Alchemist, who's got ridiculous farm, the Rubick with the counter RP steal potential. So I think Secret going to continue just to try and scrap their way to victory.
Yeah, and I like this from Pilot.
Oh, that was...
Ooh, jeez.
So close. The exit was still smoke there. It was like half a second.
Ooh! Jeez, the ice... Path nearly from the ice catching out Puppy as he TP's out. That was very close. I mean, do you feel they're at a point where VG can afford to just go for the push here? Up to the high grounds, or?
It's not easy to push high ground. Secret have good wave clear, shockwave, power shock, and just instantly take out the creep wave. Until Super's got, at minimum, an assault caress, I just don't feel like they're quite ready to do that. Now's the time where you want to have a gem. Yep, Fenrir's picked up a gem. They're going to look to get map control. Take out all of Secret's vision and start them in their base. It's kind of the position that CDEC were in earlier today against LGD, where they've got a lead. They can't just go and push high ground and take a lane of Raxo. They've got to extend it, not just get farm on Alchemist, but split the farm to the Jakiro, the Rubick, get more and more items while keeping Secret in their base and farm deprived. Secret, for the most part, can still farm on the Ember Spirit, but outside of Ember, it's very risky for other heroes to push out these lanes.
Yeah, and Palaido, he has now got that blink on the Bounty Hunter, so that's going to be obviously nice to have, especially against a lineup that does have the gems, so you can be very careful with your positioning and make sure that there's no chance that VG can close that gap in on you. And you should be also obviously have the positioning to find the tracks in the fights, which is exactly what Secret need if they want to try and close the net worth difference even more. I mean, at the moment, it's not a large difference. You know, it's only 2k favoring the side of VG, so by all means, still a very close game, but... obviously feels like VG still have the momentum in terms of kind of the play style that they've been going for.
Yeah, absolutely. You're spot on. I totally agree with the Blink Dagger pickup here with Pileidai. It just means he can still play this roaming, kind of scouting bounty hunter, trying to get map vision for his team. Without the Blink, as soon as he sees a VG hero who's just done for, but with this, he can look to Blink instantly into like trees, into a little hole, onto a cliff, and then TP out if he feels he's in danger. So, very handy item for him to have. VG Gaming doesn't look like they're in any rush to push things down despite having the Aegis, using it more just to continue to farm. Burning just with the one item, the SMY, isn't really in the best fighting shape.
TP's coming up there on the tower. Weeha, he'll be able to blink out and TP away. And the missile will continue to change at Chase Envy here. It's getting forced up back by Misery. They're trying to take it down, but the stun's still going to connect. Can they get anything follow-up from the side of VG? It doesn't look like it. Bernie's just continued to chase, and Envy just remnants back behind them and starts to build the wave. He throws another one out here. FYE stolen the remnants. He could look to chase. The telekinesis is there. Ice starts moving. He'll be able to set up the stun onto Envy. Then removing it as well. He'll be able to walk it off. Turns around the Sleight of Fist. Super's there as well. Now it's moving forward here with the remnants. Can FYE do anything to trap him down? Hasn't got the telekinesis again yet. Tracks are coming out from Pileidai, giving that extra movement speed to get away. They'll set up the ice pump again and again. Ice gets him, but the four star they're out will save MB's life. Now they'll turn around for Pileidai. They should be able to find the bounty hunter, and VG will get that kill. But the side of Secret are able to keep Envy alive there.
Ooh, Envy. It's the kind of plays he loves to make. Like, pull VG Gaming away, then go for the bit of creep skipping. Very cutesy. Almost gets punished. Pileidai has to pay for his sins, and now VG Gaming with one hero down. Knowing that Ember also actually used all of his fire remnants and TP top, he's got no TP for 18 seconds.
Oh,
he's actually out of this fight right now.
Oh, Envy. Are they going to push as well? If VG go for this.
Deja vu to Cloud9 days. Where's your TP?
Envy.
Where's your TP?
Okay, the Forever Shackle isn't going to latch. Super just frontlining. Misery does have the RP. And just for the focus fire, but VG, I think they realized that he can't quite make it back. Now he can TP back, so a little bit of a scary window is now over. Envy can turn back to the fight, and looks like on that note, VG playing a little bit more careful. They've got to be very aware that Misery's going to look to blink in. Pileidai's just been trying to get some of the tracks out here so they can see as many heroes as possible, allowing Misery to get the perfect setup. The tower falling is extremely low, and VG's still hanging around. Yeah, it's going to be Envy back at base, but he's got a remnant left on this top lane if he feels that they can force VG back and then he can get back on with the push. And it looks like, as we kind of imagined, it is very hard for VG to confidently break the high ground and look for Rax at this point of the game.
Yeah, they picked up their few key items, the Burning BKB, the Alchemist AC. It does mean they waited long enough that the Aegis has expired now. Regardless though, VG Gaming can chip away at Secret's base, kind of force Secret to engage. They don't want to engage with the Blink RP.
Misery tries to move with the Skewer, but the Yules is there. Ice lays it down, and Misery will get forced up, but it doesn't matter. Concoction finishes him off. He'll buy back straight away because they need this Magnus in the fight. They need a potential RP. Super still hanging around on the front lines. Chemical Rage will wear off shortly. They've still got the tombstone out here, BG.
Yeah,
Ember moving in, gets the chains onto Ice. He lays down the ice pop. There's your fiend script now onto the Jikiro. Misery's still hanging around, but he can't get the blink in here. The zombies from the tombstone cancelling any opportunity of an initiation. And BG will just back it off and play it safe.
Yeah, they've got to reset. Jikiro's low. The tombstone's on cooldown. Really good damage done. They force Secret to come back as five. Importantly there, Envy managed to get enough farm in the top lane by getting the T2 tower. They could buy his Crystallis and have about enough money for a buyback too, so gave Secret the damage they needed to repel BG Gaming.
He has been tracked up here, and they do have one remnant on Envy if he wants to jump forward and look for Assyrian Chains. Pilot Dice chasing him down as well, but it looks like FY is just going to be able to get himself back to the tier 2 quick enough for them to not want to chase him. Burning hanging around on the high ground, Puppy. He might find him on the wraparounds here. In fact, Burning's going to spot him out here, and Burning, he's just going to get nightmared up. He's going to continue to chase, does have a BKB if he wants to commit.
My
goodness, Burning. That creep toggle, that crit man. There's a reason why this guy's got a lot of fans, I can tell you that. He's a smart man.
The hero range creep. Not often do creeps do anything in this game apart mindlessly run down lanes and feed, but this guy here, he's a hero.
15 for 7 at the moment. That's the overall difference looking like in terms of gold. It starts to pick back up here for Vici. But 5k just 31 minutes in, and the XP just very close between these two sides. Just goes to show that this could very much swing either way. And as we've been talking about before, just winning a fight with the track gold could very well swing it even heavier back in favor of Secret. But they've got to find these fights. And at the moment, Vici are being smart. They're not giving it to them. And if anything, Vici are just constantly finding small pickoffs against the side of Secret as they're just found out of position across the map.
I think the VG Gaming edge right now is just they've got the more effective initiation with the Yule's Ice Path. On the side of Secret, their best initiation is a Blink Skewer from Magnus, as far as starting off a fight, because you're never going to be able to start a fight with a Blink RP unless VG Gaming are in a really bad position. So Blink Skewer, we saw last time, can be countered. If Ice is fast, he'll get you with the Yule Scepter. But Secret, they've tried to initiate with a Fiend's Grip as well, but that gets easily cancelled. And the Fiend's Grip is nice because it can try and group up Beachy Gaming as they run in to try and cancel it, but just wasn't quite able to kind of work out that way.
Bottom lane, VG did come down it. Misery at the moment hiding in the tree line. He reveals himself, it could be in trouble. Oh, Puppy. Oh, we've seen him just get picked off down on the Radiant Ancients, and now he's going to pay off his life again. Walks into the three of them smoked up, and they'll find the kill onto Puppy. Rubik even rubbing it in there with the stolen brain sap to finish him off, FY.
A lot of big items coming out now. FY almost with a 4-star. Got Jakiro looking to build up some items, and Outlook has a BKB now as well.
Envy will get himself away from that bottom lane, and Envy has been playing this pretty smart. He's only died one time this game, and his farm is still looking pretty good compared to the Jara. He's still only 2k behind, which in a situation like this where Vici's managed to get so much control of the map is pretty impressive. You know, he's got the Battle Fury, and I think that is now even the completed Daedalus as well. And you just gotta, you know, anticipate that with Empower. It's a lot of damage. Burning might get caught out here. They'll get the Shackle shot here. He's fairly tanky here. Do they have the damage to deal with him? They might just. And Burning is gonna go down. Nicely done there by Pilot Down. We are getting a massive pickoff.
800 gold pickoff. Bounty Hunter getting the last hit. Ideally, you probably want that going the way of the Wind Ranger. They're not done though. They know with Gyro dead.
Oh, look at that damage. Envy's just sitting here clearing out the stack with the Empower and the Daedalus. More gold into the bank here of Ember. And it looks like VG want to try and fight. They're coming back in. Misery still on the sidelines. Ice jumps straight in. We'll put the Yules onto Misery to try and take him out. Pops down the ice path. But Pylite dies there. So is Envy bringing him low. Super just jumps straight in onto Pylite die though. They'll kill the Bounty Hunter. And let's see if they can find even more here. He's still hanging around here, holding back Fenrir with the chains. He should be fine. Has the Remnant out. And yeah, he'll get himself out of there.
Feels like Vici Gaming really needs some armor now to play around with. They've got the AC on the Alchemist. I think they just need to start stacking more and more. Solar Crest seems to be the item for an Undying. I'd love to see a Vlad's on their team as well. And they just need to be able to negate as much as Ember's Sleight of Fist damage as possible.
And this is where we can see the next big fight. They're looking around the Roshan pit. It is going to be up very, very shortly. And I'm sure both teams are going to do their best to try and contest it. I don't think anyone is going to let the other team just have a walk over and take the Aegis, because both teams have the potential to take Roche really quickly, and they've also got the potential to stop someone else from doing so.
It's hard to say just how much Secret can contest it, because the tombstone on the high ground around the Roche pit is very dangerous for them. And that's where last time around, when there was a Roche fight, they just let it go because they just didn't feel confident that Magnus can get a good, clean initiation off when you haven't really got the best vision. And again, we see Vici Gaming just walk in. They don't even bother to deward first. They know there's a very high chance they've just been walked in, where they walked in detected here, and just see whether or not Bernie needs to actually join up with his team right now. It looks like he's headed towards the top lane, and his team are roaching without him.
Yeah, and obviously with that vision, Secret know they're up to it. They're not going to do anything. They will jump in and kill the Rubick here, so we are picking up a cheeky kill on the side, and Secret opting to get the push on here on the top lane. They're looking for the tier 3 here. Fortification comes out. BG will be able to finish up first Shan, get the Aegis onto Super, and they'll be back in time to defend the tier 3 as well, but the fight's kicking off here by the pit. Jumping straight in onto Puppy with the Ice Pop. Super pops the BKB. They'll get the Bane pick off. Can he find anything more here? Looking for Pilot Dice. Shackle comes out. Isn't going to latch here. We are looking for the focus fight now. Envy moves in. He's got a lot of damage. Fenrir getting out of Misery now with the RP onto Super. They're trying to take out the tombstone first, and then they'll look for the cover. Ice with the ice pump. They're skewing Super, but the chemical ray is doing a lot, charging up the concoction. They just can't kill the alchemist. He gets the stun onto Misery here, burning, trying to move in as well. Misery forces away. The shackle shot won't hold back Super. He'll continue to chase, and now ice blinking into position, gets the setup onto Weehaw, and they'll find the Weehaw Windranger as well. Super with a wicked six streak. And I've got to be honest, Daryl's performance on the Jakiro has been bang on time and time again this game.
Yeah, he's standout player right now in this game. He has been making plays all day long. The setups from this Yule's Ice Path is probably, how many of these kills? He's in 15 of the 20 kills. A lot of the ones he wasn't involved in were those early game kind of action, the kills onto the Bounty Hunter before he was even kind of rotating off the offlane. And all for the last 20, 25 minutes, every single kill has come from him. Other gem, I think the gem was actually lost since I'm dying at the final.
Yeah, I managed to get it.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
It's a pretty big swing. And you can look at that as kind of an 1800 gold swing, since Secret can make use of that as far as dewarding and looking to get back some map control for themselves. Importantly for Vici Gaming, they do still have the Aegis. Now boots have traveled up on Super as well, and this is where the next siege of this mid lane of Rax could come out of Vici Gaming. Burning's MKB now complete as well.
Yeah, they're still going to be so careful of this combo that can come out from Secret. The fact that Envy, now sitting on 3.3k gold, I mean, pushing into high ground is going to be so hard still for VG.
Absolutely. It's also hard because he's continuously split pushing this top lane whenever they try and group up and go down the mid lane. Alchemist now with Boots of Travel can finally deal with this in a lot of ways. He can just push out top and then TP in to help out his team. And up until this pickup, it felt like Secret were always going to just be able to push out and threaten the top lane. We see the tier 3 tower already down to about 400 HP, and Vici Gaming, they're actually going to fake back.
Pilot Eye, he's got to be a little bit careful where he wanders here. He will dispel the smoke here onto Fenrir, but MVE's been called out straight away by FY, blinking in with the telekinesis. Ice Path is laid down. Can he get himself out? No! They'll get the kill. Envy down and out for the count. 76 seconds on the clock, and VG getting pretty much the best pickoff they could have hoped for there in their own jungle.
That was clever. They were just grouping up, going down the mid lane as if they were making a beeline for the Rax with four heroes. They show the Alk top, so if you're a Secret, you're thinking, okay, they're pushing mid with four, Alchemist is going to TP in, let's split push the side lanes. You can't split push top because the Alk's there, so Ember's bottom, but as soon as they cleared one more creep wave, Vici Gaming just smoke and make a just gunshot towards bottom lane, and they're there to meet the Ember Spirit as he arrives and find that pickoff. Now they look to force his buyback.
Yeah, here we go. And oh, Super getting forced deep into the base, but Misery won't be able to get the obscure off. They get the shackle shot onto two. Burning moving in there with a cooldown. Fiend's Grip has been dropped down onto Ice Side, but the damage for Super. They'll find the bait. There's a buyback here from Ember. Can Ember do anything to return this? Fenrir fairly low. Gets a slight out, but can't soon change up the gyro as his BKB is still on. Puppy throws out the Nightmare onto Super. Let's see if they can follow it up. They've still got the RP here, but the toggle off of the Nightmare, because if focus fired down Super, they've got the track as well to chase him down. Fenrir will TP out. Looks like Super will be left behind, and they'll get him once. He's got the Aegis, but there's no backup from the side of VG, and Secret, with these buybacks, they'll be able to defend the base and get a fair few kills under their belt as well. Very nicely held by Secret, and this is what we're talking about time and time again, how Secret have every kind of tool that they need to hold the high ground.
Yeah, the high ground defense with an Ember Spirit just so potent. Does cost some buybacks to the point where they really gain that much in terms of overall gold. The Bounty Hunter, the only real hero that actually gained net worth there. The Windranger dropping a full 1,000 net worth. Yeah, it does cost them 3 buybacks, including the embers, and that's where it doesn't really feel like a big secret victory there.
No.
They break the Aegis, they buy themselves some time, but we go back to that state of the game where Vici Gaming probably unwilling to go for a push. They'd rather go for a smoke gank, see if they can pick off one of those heroes who just use their buyback, and then they will try and make the attempt on Rax. If they can't find a pickoff, we may just see this game draw out until another Roshan's respawn.
And he's got to be so careful, because he could be that pickoff that they find.
Yeah.
And he just remnants out there. But no, yeah, you're absolutely right. They've got this 6-minute window now, VG, where they know that this could be incredibly painful for Secret. And Secret, well, maybe they want to try and play off this and try and do something that VG Gaming might not expect. Moving in on the top lane, smoked up. They do, of course, still have that RP here on Misery. Maybe they can find a fighter, but no, F5 blinks forward straight away with the telekinesis onto Misery. They throw down the ice path as well. F5 just getting himself out at 8 HP. Burning moving forward, they'll still find the kill onto the Rubick. And now Weehive's looking for more. This power cooldown coming out onto Puppy. Gets four-staffed out of this. Envy trying to move back forward. They'll take down the Tombstone. With FY down, they may look to move in for more here, Secret. FY does not have buyback, and they still have not had to use this RP from Misery.
Not the biggest loss for VG Gaming as far as the Rubick's concerned. Almost surviving. 5 HP and then the Power Shot's knife. Secret can't really push off of this. Going high ground against the VG Gaming lineup is not going to really work for them. Super getting close to maxed out as well in this Alchemist. I think an Abyssal Blade would make a nice last item pickup. Problem is, Alchemist, once you get past like 45-50 minutes, starts to fall off as far as the hero's carry potential goes. He can continue to contribute to the team by starting to pull Acceptors. We could well see an Undying with an Aghanim Scepter pulled, a Rubick with an Aghanim Scepter pulled. There are some good heroes to be giving that upgrade to.
Has to be a little bit careful how close he comes. He has got the backup, but at the same time, he's tracked up on Weeha. He's got a lot of damage now. If he shackles someone with that Daedalus and the Aghanims, he will be able to burst them down. But at the same time, we've already seen how much that VG have in terms of disrupt, just getting themselves in with the Yule Scepters, the Telekinesis. So they'll be doing everything in their power to ensure that Windranger can't just sit there and lock down onto one hero and take them out of the fight.
And Secret, again, splitting the map. They send one or two heroes top, they've got one or two at bottom. The Ember actually pushes that bottom and then heads towards top, knowing that he's likely to draw the Vici Gaming attention. And will then proceed to back off. An Eagle Song actually picked up EE.
Okay, I mean, a little bit unfortunate that this is kind of at the same time that the Super has just picked up a completed MKB.
Yeah, and that's just where... I wonder if there's any chance this is an Ethereal Blade. Just, you can use it to save teammates. There's a lot of right-click physical damage now that the Gyro has MKB and likely to kind of round things off with his item build for another damage item, something like a Butterfly.
Just the fact that they've got two MKBs on the side of VG, you know what I mean? The fact that, it's... Well, we'll see what he does with it. Maybe, as you said, thinking about the E-Blade. But, I mean, Butterfly, of course, will still offer a fair bit in terms of the right-click. He's already got a lot under his belt, level 22. With the Daedalus, the Battle Fury, and that Empower.
He's asking for a bottle. He wants Misery's bottle right now.
Let's get a DD.
Yep, this is... Have they not seen it? They'll see it now. Misery. Is he going to take this? He should be pulling it either to the Windranger or the Ember. Looks like Windranger will be the one who gets it.
Okay. And so Secret at the moment, they're kind of halfway through this rocky patch in terms of the timings on the buyback statuses. We've got about 2.5 minutes left, so they've been through the first 3.5 of the 6 or so.
Yep.
So it's getting to that point where they feel a little bit more confident, and I mean, regardless of that, they've not really slowed down the aggression, as you said. They've been split pushing the entirety of the map. They've really been going out, and they're not playing any more defensive than they were before. They're still keeping it up at the high pace that we like to see.
Well, for VG Gaming, their lineup is, you can kind of notice right now, it's starting to fall off. For a Secret, you've got heroes like Windranger who are just going to get stronger and stronger as they pick up more items. Already the Daedalus is complete. You could see like a BKB type pickup come next. Magnus giving the Empower to both these carries means they've got a lot more late game damage output. Ember Spirit will have that extra bit of cleave and damage. Ember's going to get more and more farmed as well. And on the Radiant side, the Gyro can kind of round things off with a Butterfly or some other items to kind of give him a bit more late game damage, but not a hero as well known for his insane late game carry potential.
And it looks like, at the moment, Secret, I mean, at this point, do both teams just hang around for Roshan? It is shortly going to be back up.
This is the first Roshan I feel Secret may look to contest.
Yeah.
If they can get some good vision up around the pit, to me, they've finally got the items they need. The Daedalus on the Windranger. The DD room picked up. If only Rosh respawns soon enough, it looks like 15 seconds from now. But Vici Gaming already rushing in to contest the Rosh pit area.
And of course, I believe this is the third brochure. Will be the cheese as well here, if they can get it. But as you said, I don't think the side of Secret will let them get away with it as free as they did last time.
Importantly, the buybacks will be online. If VG Gaming get a free roast, let's say they get Aegis and cheese, Secret will have buybacks for the high ground defense. And as we saw last time, it's not easy for VG Gaming to break the mid lane of Rax when Secret have buybacks. And even on top of that, you lose the mid lane. I don't think one lane of Rax is going to be game changing, not with this Secret draft.
And it does look like Envy, so he's not going to be doing anything a bit different here with E-Blade. He's going to still go for that butterfly. Has the quarterstaff and the courier, and yeah, there we go. He's going to buy it straight up now. So he's going to have that ready for the next fight, and he does still have the buyback goal pretty much on top of it as well. So not taking any risks. And Secret, they'll be able to get it. Yep. VG just not in the close by area. And that's going to be Aegis now picked up by Weeha. They've got the cheese on Envy as well, and this may be what the side of Secret need to try themselves to look to push down another tier 2 and maybe even try and break high ground against the side of VG.
Oh yeah, how the times have changed now that it's Secret getting an uncontested Roche. VG Gaming, they had a ward around the pit and it was such a fast Roche respawn. I think they were just taking a gamble that they could back off, defend and push out the top lane and hope that Roche didn't respawn as fast as they did. Or if Roche does respawn, that ward spots Secret go in. But Secret just blink in with the Windranger, use the Solar Crest from the Bane and Roche just drops too fast for them. Once that TP top from the Alchemist is there, there's no one coming back to get to the pit in time.
And a nice pickup here, of course, from Misery. He's got the completed BKB on him now as well, so he's going to find it even easier to try and find these big RPs. I mean, we're yet really to kind of see a big one here 45 minutes in, but
we're also yet to see an FY steal. So, like, this Rubick has been not a complete non-factor, set up a number of kills and been useful through the telekinesis, but the actual spell steals have not come into play at all.
And I kind of feel it's because we just really haven't seen Secret commit to a full-on fight. It's been these kind of smaller skirmishes, smaller pickoffs that have been very kind of short-lived and no kind of prolonged engagements between the sides, as both teams being relatively smart at when they pull out the fights and they don't need to stick around for longer than they need to.
Well, talk about the armor game, and it will be Ice also picking up a plate mail. No one needs to negate as much damage as the embers as possible. There's still a lot of downsides to this, though. He would love to have a late-game Hex. I feel like getting a Hex is almost going to be needed here in the late game to deal with Ember Spirit, but it's like you go for the Hex, you're too squishy, you're going to die to the Slide of Fist before you can even get in range to use it. You go for some extra armor, you don't have the lockdown you need to deal with the Ember. So Secret very much the ones in control all of a sudden. Holgraf still
it's
in
so
favor
close.
Of VG Gaming, but don't feel it tells the whole story.
Oh, if they catch out Envy here, they're straight in. The full team moving in. Can he get himself that time? Eats the cheese. Will he be able to save himself? Yes, he remnants out. Oh, no, he remnants back in. Oh, Envy, that was not the play here. Backup is on his way, though. Maybe Misery can find it. Goes for an RP. It's only on to Burning here. They'll lose Envy here. He's down. They'll have the Fiend's Reborn to Pharaoh. Maybe Secret can clean up. They found the Gyro. They'll find Pharaoh as well. The Shackle Shot for We Are. On to two. Double kill for the Rim Ranger. Maybe even make that a triple. No, it's going to be Misery to find. And the Eternal Envy bait working out for Secret. They lose the Ember, but they take four in return, and Secret will look to power down the top lane off the back of that very fruitful team fight. Look at the gold swing, look at the XP swing, the biggest fight that we've seen so far in this game.
Oh man, they just took too long to bring down the Ember. They needed to get him in that first burst with the telekinesis ice path, and Alchemist never actually reached up to the fight.
Oh, super! He's gonna put the BKB here. He's got the Concoction charging up as well, so he should be alright. He's got to be careful though, he's all on his own here in the base. We are trying to look for a cheeky shackle, but the distance isn't quite great enough.
He's still tracked though, so he can't even go near this, and it looks like they will just give up at least a tier 3 tower, possibly more with Weeha having an Aegis.
Oh.
And should a fight break out, Envy can buy back and TP in.
Puppy.
VG Gaming do not want to overcommit to this fight.
Oh, Weeha. He's going to be very happy just going straight in. Wim runs himself away, gets forced out as well. And we are going to see the lineup of VG now come back onto the board. So they get a bit of damage done to the melee racks, but that will, of course, regen back up. So they get the tier 3. So now we're kind of in a similar position that VG were when they pushed down the mid lane. But at the same time, as you said, with Secret's lineup and the way that the last fights have been going, it certainly feels like it's Secret getting the momentum all the way back in their favor. Ice moving forward, seeing if he can catch out Misery. But Misery's going to be there with the Blink Force out. And there's now actually a very late game Dagon being picked up here on this Bounty Hunter.
Trying to just have more burst damage, and there's not really any clear
items. He's getting telekinesis jewels up as well. They'll get the lockdown here and the damage. It's going to be a fair bit. He'll turn around with the brain sap and the Nightmare trying to get himself out of it, but it's not going to work. Even went for the Fiend's Grip there, but Super with the Concoction will blow him up. That's Puppy down for 70 seconds. He does have buyback. And we'll see if VG now try and push themselves on the mid lane now that they're taking one down. And Envy is going to go for that blink dagger. We see some embers do this towards the latter portions of the game just to help them with the split push and feel a little bit safer when trying to play around the opponents.
Yeah, the item synergizes so well with Ember's skill set. You can blink in for the slide and then have the fire run escape rather than initiate. You can also, if you get a really long slide of fist off while you're like being ganked, it buys you the 2 to 3 seconds you need for your blink to come back up, so you can blink out after the slide.
Misery's looking for the skewer here. Won't find it, but the shackle shot! Oh my goodness! Gets it on Super. They'll still blink back. Buy back from Puppies. They realize they've got to fight Super first. The concussion out to me. The damage with the fascia. Misery's just getting ripped to shreds. He'll buy back here as well. Now Puppies caught out by the telekinesis. Will he be able to get himself out? He wants the ghost scepter. Cooldown's going to be there. They'll be able to find the kill onto Puppy. He is going to go down. So that's a dieback here on the Bane. Puppy out of the fight for 70 seconds. Nice, looking to set something up. But Weehar's there. Looks for the Shaq. He's going to find it. Moves it. But there's the RP. Gets two. And they'll look to find Super as well as FY's Rubik. Super's going to go down. Three kills here for Secret. Ferrer looks for the TP out. Can they cancel it? No, they can't. But nonetheless, they find three. Now Secret are going to look for the push here. No buyback here on Ice. No buyback on FY. This could be the opening, and of course, with that recent pickup of the Desolator on the Windranger, they're going to be taking structures like there's no tomorrow.
You know, this Dagon pickup for Pi is the anti-Rubik item, because Rubik is trying to rely on the Ghost Scepter to stay alive against Ember. If he ever pops it, he gets Dagon Shuriken, and when Rubik's out of the picture, Misery is getting RPs off. He's being so patient, respecting FY's playmaking ability. He's always holding onto the RP until Rubik is dead, and killing the Rubik is just so easy, because VG Gaming use all their initiation and lockdown on heroes like Ember and Windranger, so Bounty can just run in and take out Rubik. Not to mention, VG Gaming lost their gem. They haven't had a gem for like since that last terrible team fight, so it's very hard to play against this Bounty Hunter right now. They can only rely on the sentries, and it's just not cutting it for VG.
Yeah, Puppy's going to be back up now. He, of course, does. He's going to have that buyback on cooldown, but you look at the side of VG, and of course, the fact that Super had to buy back then, it means that if anything, it's VG in the weaker position at the moment. If they can kill Super once more, he's going to have pretty much close to 100 second cooldown on him in terms of respawn time. And that you've got it. If they can get the lockdown on the key heroes like Envy, they're going to have a good chance taking this fight. But as well, they've got to be so scared of Weehar. We've seen him in this late game just getting perfect shackles each and every fight and just being able to just destroy and just delete the cores of VG.
Yeah. And if this Windranger can farm a like Monkey King bar on top of the Daedalus Deso, good luck staying alive. Alchemist is going to suffer versus this, and fairly close to it. We'll be looking to sell the phase boots to get there, and I worry for VG Gaming. Their late game just isn't feeling all that impressive right now. They've really fallen off with the Undying of Rubik. Alchemist not going for the farm build means even at 52 minutes, he hasn't pulled an Aghanim Scepter, and he's unlikely to do so anytime soon. By the time he can afford one, his buyback's going to be up, so he's more likely to want to hold onto the money to have buyback. And as good as like Undying or a Rubik Ag Scepter can be, it's not game-changing. It's not like, okay, Rubik's now got an Ags, it's going to change the entire game. Could make a difference. It makes Rubik a bit tanky. He can stay alive and still hope that RP steal, but I just don't think Misery's going to let him have it. Misery's just been so on point this game.
Yeah, he has indeed. And that's going to be Envy now. He does invest in, I believe, the... No, he's not bought the Demon Edge yet, but he's closing in on having the money for that. And of course, wants to make sure he is going to have buyback available for the next fight as well. And he's just a couple of hundred away from having both buyback and a completed Monkey King bar here on December. We've already seen the amount of damage that Envy can kick out in these team fights. And I've got to be honest, Envy has been playing very sensibly this game. Yeah. He's only died three times. He's been pushing out the lanes beautifully. And now at this point where he's starting to get pretty much six-slotted, he's just so, so scary in these team fights for VG.
I wonder if Jairu saw this MKB now, he might stop buying the butterfly. He's sending it to the shop now. It looks like he's going to complete it. And this is going to be instantly counted. MKB already online. Yep. Still like a decent item. Gives you some armor, some attack speed, a bit of damage. But it feels desperate enough, he may have even considered going for a rapier if he saw that MKB. Level 3 Dagon for Pylaidai. Continuing to get more items just to try and burst down the Rubik.
And again, we may see this kind of passivity from both sides as Roshan is going to be up fairly shortly.
Yeah. And Magnus also with buyback on cooldown. So for Secret, despite Alk not having a buyback, despite being really strong right now, having just got a couple of key items, are not going to try and push their luck. Secret, with the benefit of having some scouting capabilities with the fire room. This is helping them keep tabs of Roshan. They're going to know about it instantly. Beachy Gaming in the neighborhood, and it looks like Super will actually find it.
And yeah, go this it. Is going to be the fight, almost certainly. Neither team is going to want to let the other get away with this.
They have zero buybacks. No Gyro, no Alchemist buyback. They do it in front of the Remnant.
Okay.
They say, come at us, Secret.
And Secret certainly will. We are moving, and he's got an Invis rune as well here, so he could set up something. The potential Shackle Sock coming in here, but Envy blinks himself out. And look at the damage here from Weehawk. Ice gets deleted. And we'll be able to get the Roshan. So Super's got the Aegis here. Gets the bash onto Pylite Eye. One for one at the moment here. There's going to be the buyback now from Pylite Eye, realizing that they want to go all in on this fight. Weehawk blinking himself away. FY looking to try and catch by the damage. He gets off the telekinesis, the Ghost Scepter. They'll get the Invisible Blade down to Weehawk. They get the kill. Wind Ranger's down and out for the count. Concoction will connect onto Puppy here. BG trying to move in for more. And the bash is here, and the MKB procs as well. Puppy, he's got himself a Glimmer Cape, but they don't have the gem at the moment here. Puppy looking for the jukes. Does he get himself out of it? Yeah, looks like he's going to be able to TP away. Puppy gets himself out. But at the same time, top lane, Envy is looking at the racks here. VG Super's coming. He's got the Chemical Rage, and it is just Envy here on his own at the moment as Misery backs out as well.
Well, a great fight for VG Gaming, securing Roshan, but it's not over.
Pylite Eye pinging out to Burning, a bit of RP, and they'll use it straight away, gets it off here, and Burning taken down. Big pick off there for Secret. There is buyback available on the Gyrocopter. They want to try and force it here. They don't have Wind Ranger back up for 50 seconds, but that's going to be a good 30-second interval between Weehawk being back up and Burning still being out for the count.
Yeah, and with Jakura Rubick respawn, not sure if Secret to try and press and force this buyback. Does feel like a slightly risky play to make. The kill potential with the Alchemical Blade is there, and
they would have got that off as well. It was the MKB proc there that kind of cancelled Jakiro being able to cast anything, so that was Envy playing with death here at the moment.
These Team Secret 4 staffs have been incredibly crucial in all of these fights and clashes, helping just to kite around.
Puppy. He's going to be forced out by Misery, but Jakiro.
These Team 4 staffs saving lives time and time again. That's the second time in a row Puppy's been helped
out. FY's got a gem here, moves him with the telekinesis. Alchemist coming in, forced forward here, gets the concoctions done off. They've got the ice path laid down as well. Misery, he can't get himself in with the blink of the tombstone. He's been out. The forcing of the sliding here. There'll be a nightmare onto Super. We'll set up a shackle shot here. Can they burst in the air? Yes, they can. Super down. And now with the feed script onto ice to find Jakiro as well. Super's going to be back here for round two. With the courier, in fact, flying over. Super looking for the TP. They've got the damage. Yeah, no! He's down! Full team wipers, Envy cleans up from the back! And VG, they haven't got Fenrir buyback, they haven't got Super buyback either as well. Burning will be back up for the defense, they can buy back on Ice. But this is going to be a hard defense from VG.
And they go straight
game,
for Throne.
They're just going for it.
They've got Wind Ranger, they've got huge damage output.
Burning, they've got up here as well. They'll use it straight up, and this is massive because they get Burning here. He does have buyback, I believe, with the amount of God he has. He turns around, it's not enough. He will buyback almost certainly, but they've lost Jakiro. He's the only one who can return to defend the base. Secret all so damn low. I mean, Envy's going to TP himself back out. Pylite Eye nearly dying to the tower. He's fine, and there's the buyback on Burning Gyro.
They're playing it safe. They're going to the rack. Everybody's so low. They know they just want to make sure they secure a big enough advantage.
Envy
returning to the fight. Pops a BKB.
He wants to go
for his TPs.
1v1 me, he says, but Burning's damage is pretty substantial. You've got to be careful, Envy. Super's there as well. He has a concoction. Envy will be able to blink himself away. Super pops the BKB to make sure he doesn't stun himself. But they do hold VG here. Top lane. They're moving in onto Puppy, and they should be able to find this kill with Burning and FY. They'll get the pick off. And they do hold the base, only losing the melee racks in the mid lane there from BG.
I don't know how. If they just focused on the racks, they dived a bit too deep, took a lot of damage. Ember trying to just man fight with the BKB TP in. And possibly not the best approach for Secret when they went onto the high ground. They could have gotten two lanes of racks, I imagine, there if they'd prioritized. And BG Gaming are going to look to push right back. Buyback status on Ember, positive. Wind Ranger, also positive.
Yeah,
that's the two key heroes. Bounty buys a Dagon 5, could have a buyback, but I think just feeling confident that his positioning is going to kind of keep him away from BG Gaming. And BG Gaming, like, you're never thinking, let's go on a Bounty Hunter. You're always looking for the Wind Ranger and the Ember Spirit should a fight break out.
Yeah, and just to note as well, Ember Spirit Envy, so what he's been doing, I don't know if you've noticed, that he's got the BKB, but he's leaving it in base, just picking it up, popping the active, and then getting himself out on the map here to just make sure that he's got these slots he needs for these other key items. So potentially 7 slotted at the moment on Envy.
Yeah, I don't really think he can upgrade too many of these items at this stage. The Blink Dagger, it just offers so much to him as far as mobility and split push potential. Secret looking to get aggressive here. One pick off and it's just game over. Out not having buyback.
Oh, he's buying Axe. Who's he going to give it to? Who did he give it to? Gave it to who's he giving it? Must be.
Was it Rubik?
Yeah, he's not giving it yet. It's just coming out.
Done anything yet.
Who's he going to get? Who's going to get it? Who's his favorite?
We're searching. We're fishing.
Yeah.
Rubik.
Ah, it's Rubik. FY is the chosen one. FY now with the Aghanims.
Makes him a lot tankier.
Yep.
Not most importantly, but that's a nice side benefit. But if he can get some clutch steals, not a single RP steal all game long. Don't even think we've seen a Fiend's Grip get stolen just because Puppy's always positioned so far back.
This is it. This is the defense that VG need to pull off. No buybacks at the moment on the side of VG Gaming. I think Secret realized. And keeping themselves hanging around mid, they're just head the MV back up to the top lane to start getting that creep wave pushed in. They want to have all lanes pushed in before looking for the big commitment onto the high ground, just to make sure it doesn't go bad. And even if it does, they may be in a position where they don't need to buy back. But Vici's Gaming's push is going to be so strong, they'll almost certainly be able to power straight down a lane here as Secret lose a fight. But Secret do have that backup of having multiple buybacks online.
Yeah.
Oh, is that the second Aidless?
Oh,
wait, hang on.
Damage
yes, output. It is. Yeah, uh-oh. It is. Oh, we are getting caught out here. Slide coming through from MV. RP! It will only get burned again. Try to steal him out, but the BKBs are out for VG. Looking to chase this one down. Super moving forward, but there's your Fiend's Grip. And now with the Shackle Shot, Super just gets melted. FY moving forward. He's looking for something. We are. Will is his life, so one for one at the moment. Ember coming back into the fight, going forward onto Burning, but the damage from the Gyro is pretty enough. Dazzle, FY screwing forward. Telekinesis here onto Ember. Pops the Ghost Scepter here, tries to wall back out. Ice Path coming out from Ice Ice. Won't catch anyone. FY healed up, Jensen back himself out, she's coming out, but they've lost two on the side of VG here, burning incredibly low as well. If they lose him, this could be it. Three down on VG Gaming, and GG is called. Secret take game one of this best of three, and gods, I think that game was everything we hoped it to be.
Absolutely fantastic. Bloody good Dota right here.
My
between
goodness.
Secret and VG Gaming. Everyone on Secret showing up to play here. It's one of those things where it's like, how do you pick an MVP or something like that when everybody played so well? Misery did not let FY get his hands on RP.